Happy New Year. Happy 2009 from all of us at NBC Sports. Dave Strader alongside Eddie Olczyk and the rest of our crew here this afternoon at Wrigley Field for the 2009 Winter Classic. Time to meet the Bridgestone team captains. We begin with Pierre McGuire.
Nick, is this just like Västerås, Sweden, where you grew up?
This is a lot like growing up back home, you know, playing outdoors. And even though the weather is actually great for playing outdoors today.
This rivalry is so intense. How important is it, the 2 points in the standings? You guys focused on that?
Yeah, we're focused on the game itself, too, even though it's great festivity. But we know there are 2 points up for grabs, and, you know, it's a tight race with the Blackhawks right now.
Thanks, Nick. Have fun today.
Sure will. Thank you.
Darren, over to you with Jonathan Taves.
Pierre, thank you very much. Your father in Winnipeg, Manitoba, built a lot of awesome rinks outdoors. How does this one compare, and what are your feelings heading into this game here?
It's a little more complicated, I guess, to build a rink out here, but it's pretty cool, and obviously compares to where I grew up playing hockey, so it's pretty special right now.
What about the fans here and the rivalry that you have with the Detroit Red Wings?
Oh, it's unbelievable. You know, there's a little bit... few Wings fans out there, but I think we got the home crowd advantage, so hopefully we can take advantage of it.
Jonathan, have fun and good luck today.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Dave Strader?
Well, Jonathan Taves is right. I think the Blackhawks have an edge. They lead the National Hockey League in attendance at their home at the United Center, which Bob Costas already talked about. I think it's safe to say the Detroit Red Wings lead the National Hockey League in road attendance, over 18,500 average as they tour around the National Hockey League, but no venue like this one here this afternoon with over 41,000 fans, Ed.
Well, the Red Wings well represented here from the people of Detroit coming to Wrigley Field, and a great day for hockey here in the city of Chicago. And hard to believe we're going to have a face-off in short center field at Wrigley Field here to break in the new year.
Well, it's not just going to be a face-off. Before they actually drop the puck to start the game, they're going to have a ceremonial puck drop. And of course, there's quite a few Hall of Famers in attendance, but look at the hats. Mike Babcock on the right, the head coach. That's Paul McLean on the left, who Eddie Olczyk played in Winnipeg along with you. So the cold weather, Paul McLean's no stranger to that.
Got to try to keep the heat in as much as you can. The players' benches are heated. The coaches will get a little bit of that, but more for the players. But the throwbacks there, and like almost like the old high school jackets for Joel Quinville on the left, the head coach, and John Torchetti on the right. Trains stay warm, and throwback uniforms for both these teams and also for the coaches' attire as well.
Don McDonough is the new president of the Chicago Blackhawks and a longtime member of the Chicago Cubs organization, and was president of that organization as well. He has to be extremely proud about the way this whole thing looks. And now we take a look at some of the Hall of Famers. That's Billy Williams, or is that Ferguson Jenkins that is waving, the one-time Chicago Cubs pitcher. Of course, once a junior B hockey player as he grew up
Chatham,
in Canada.
Ontario.
Stan Mikita to the left, and to the right, that is Tony Esposito. And that was Billy Williams, the slugger, not Ferguson Jenkins, who is also in attendance, but Billy Williams, a longtime Chicago Cub, and we have so many dignitaries in attendance here this afternoon. There's Ryan Sandberg, who has talked in many articles leading up to this event about his love for the game of hockey, his love for the Chicago Blackhawks. And there is Denny Savard, who started the season as coach. Mike Milbury briefly referred to the fact that the Blackhawks made a coaching change just 4 games in. Not many coaches win their last game before they're fired, but Denny Savard did, defeating the Phoenix Coyotes in a game at the United Center before the change was made to Joel Quenneville. But hard to argue with the results.
17-point improvement for the Chicago Blackhawks last year under Denny Savard. They wanted to go with a little bit more experience. They went with Joel Quenneville and certainly up the conference standings in the West.
There's Ferguson Jenkins. Grew up in Canada, of course, an outstanding pitcher for the Chicago Cubs. And there's also been a lot of talk about all the athletes from the other teams, Eddie Olczyk. I'm sure you experienced it when you played here, when Chicago, the Blackhawks were more in the limelight of the sporting scene in Chicago. But all the other athletes from the other sports are so excited about this event.
Oh, always. And, you know, you have that relationship with the White Sox, the Cubs, the Bulls, the Bears, and, of course, the Blackhawks. And you know what? Athletes, they're fans too. They go out to different venues and get those opportunities to come and see these great events. But this is something people will remember forever.
Well, now they're introducing Terrible Ted Lindsay. And it's hard to believe, if you know Ted as a gentleman since his many years of playing in the National Hockey League with both Detroit and Chicago. People might forget he spent 3 years as a Blackhawk as a teammate of this man, Bobby Hull, who was a member of the last Chicago Stanley Cup winning team in 1961. And the two of them will be involved in the ceremonial puck drop at center ice. Of course, Ted Lindsay's number 7 is retired by the Detroit Red Wings. Hangs in the rafters at the Joe Louis Arena. And the great Bobby Holland went on to an outstanding career in the WHA after his years here in Chicago. Nick Lidstrom and Jonathan Toews, the two active captains. And that's something else this Blackhawk organization has done, is welcome back the likes of Bobby Hall, Stan Mikita, hiring Denny Savard as an ambassador, even after letting him go as a coach. They've done so much to try to bring this back together as a family.
And Tony Esposito as well, Dave. And just a lot of things going on positively. You mentioned John McDonough. He spent 25-plus years with the Chicago Cubs, broadcasting, marketing, and then became the team president. And as we heard Patrick Kane telling us before the game, you know what? John McDonough was here, now he's with us, and now we're here on New Year's Day at Wrigley Field.
Let's go down inside the glass to Pierre McGuire.
Well, both teams are jacked up, obviously, but I can tell you right now, there's a pretty significant wind blowing into the face of the Detroit Red Wings, and you can see almost snow particles blowing down the ice into the Red Wings goaltender's face, Ty Conklin. This is going to be an issue for the goaltenders as we go along. Talking to Darren Pang while we were on the ice interviewing Jonathan Toews and Nick Lidstrom, he was saying, and he's a former goaltender, it's going to be tough with the lighting for the goaltender, so we could have plenty of goals here this afternoon in Chicago.
Let's go to Darren Pang for an update on the conditions and how it might affect the goaltenders.
Well, I talked to Colin Campbell, of course, of the National Hockey League, about possibly changing ends at the 10-minute mark of every period, not just the third period. Colin said that's not going to happen. I talked to Dale Talon, the GM, yesterday, and he was concerned about the sun, but obviously without the sun, that's not an issue. But Pierre makes a great point about the wind. It is coming from the south, which is the right of Cristobal Huue, so obviously there's going to be tears in the eyes when the wind's blowing from that side. So it could cause problems in terms of the vision for the goaltenders.
Bill McCreary will drop the puck at center ice. Tim Peel is the other referee. Andy McCallum and Dan Schachter, the linesman. The Red Wings wearing uniforms from their first season in the NHL when they were the Detroit Cougars back in 26-20.